I wrote the DDR as DRAM controller from scratch. It's done. And it is working. Kind of working. It's working in the simulation. On the device, it's not working most of the time. So a quick recap. In the last video, I said I'm going to write my own DDR controller from scratch. To prove it's actually working, I wrote a program that fills the whole memory in pseudorandom data and then makes sure it is able to read it back. I can actually get it to run, but I get occasional bit flips, data that is read in differently than what was written, usually in just one or two bits. Worse, sometimes two consecutive reads return different values. How do bit flips happen? When you look at the datasheet for electrical components, you typically see a section called timing or AC characteristics or some other name. They specify how someone communicating with the device needs to time the signals for the device to work properly, as well as what behavior one can expect from the device. Two specific parameters of note here are setup time and hold time. When working with synchronous devices, we have a clock edge that triggers the operation. There's a problem, however. No electronics can sample at infinite speed. For the data signal to be sampled correctly, it needs to be stable a certain amount of time before the clock edge arrives, and also a certain amount of time after the clock edge is passed. These are the setup time and hold time, respectively. If either setup or hold times are not observed, i.e. if the data signal changes within setup time before the clock or hold time after, then it's not guaranteed that the correct value will be registered. In other words, we might get a bit flip. We're working with the DDR chip in the slowest clock speed officially supported, around 303 MHz. There is some configuration and room for design, but it currently seems as if the FPGA is simply not fast enough to do it at that speed. As a side note, I've scripted a video explaining about the interfaces to DDR memory, explaining the different terms used and the concepts involved. I then looked at it and wasn't sure it was interesting enough. I shelved it for now, but let me know in the comments or otherwise if hearing what double data rate synchronous dynamic random access memory actually means in practice is of interest to you. Anyways, like I said, it seems that the FPGA on the QMTEC board is simply not fast enough for our needs. It's possible that the reason I couldn't get the third-party implementations to work is that it is simply impossible to get them to work. Look what I got. A couple of months ago, I was browsing Mouser, and I noticed a certain FPGA was scheduled to be available with a short lead time, relatively speaking. This FPGA is the Spartan 7 S25, which is almost twice the size of the S15 on the QMTEC board. It also has a higher speed grade, meaning it should be able to handle higher clock rates. Best of all, it is supposed to be pin compatible with the S15 already on the board. I immediately ordered three, and today, 2 months ahead of schedule, they arrived. Next, I'm going to try and replace the FPGA on the board with its bigger, faster brother. I'll then recheck the DDR controller to see whether that fixes things for us. So this is it for now. If you're tired of the DDR chapter for this project taking so long, my only consolation is that I've been spending almost all of my free time on this for the past 3 months. Just think how I feel about it. And though I'm learning a lot, I don't have anything to show for it yet. So for now, thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.